Lecture 9, Internet Technologies. Introduction to Internet Technologies, Architecture, the Client Server and Peer-to-Peer, Structure of Web, Web Server and Web Applications, Object Model of the Document, HTTP, HTML, CSS, JavaScript, AJAX, CSM. Correlation with databases, frameworks, XML, web services, the service-oriented architecture, safety injection, and cross-attack to the website. Client-server model. In the client-server model, all end systems are divided into clients and servers, each designed for specific purposes. Client have an achieve role and initiate a communication session by sending requests to server clients. Clients must have knowledge of the available server and the service devices they provide. Clients can communicate with servers only. They cannot see each other. Servers have a passive role and respond to their clients by acting on each request and returning results. One server generally supports numerous clients. Structure. The layout and content of your web page are defined by HTML. HTML stands for hypertext markup language. It allows you to describe the basic cycle structure of a document using HTML tags. Each HTML tag describes a specific element on the document. Look and feel. To define the look and feel of a web page, web developers use CSS, which stands for cascading style sheets. CSS is a language that lets you describe how the elements defined in your HTML should be styled, allowing changes in font, color, layout, simple animations, and other superficial elements. Extensible markup language, XML, is used to describe data. The XML standard is a flexible way to create information formats and electronically share structured data via the public internet as well as via corporate new networks. XML code, a formal recommendation from the World Wide Web Consortium, is similar to hypertext markup language HTML. Both XML and HTML contain markup symbols to describe page or file content. HTML code describes web page content only in terms of how it is to be displayed and interacted with. And XML data is known as self-describing or self-defining, meaning that the structure of the data is embedded with the data. Thus, when the data arrives, there is no need to pre-build the structure to store the data. It is dynamically understood within the XML. The XML format can be used by any individual or group of individuals or companies that want to share information in a consistent way. XML is actually a similar and easier to use subset of the standard generalized markup language, which is the standard to create a document structure. Extensible hypertext markup language is part of the family of XML markup language. It mirrors or extends versions of the widely used hypertext markup language HTML, the language in which web pages are formulated. JavaScript. JavaScript is an interpreted programming of or script language from Netscape. In general, script language are easier and faster to code in than the more structured and compiled language such as C and C++. Script languages generally take longer to process than compiled languages, but are very useful for shorter programs. JavaScript is used in website development to do such things as automatically change a formatted date on a web page, cause a link to page or to appear in a pop-up window, cause text or a graphic image to change during a mouse rollover. JavaScript uses some of the same ideas found in Java. The compiled object-oriented programming divided from C++, JavaScript code can be embedded in HTML pages and interpreted by the web browser or client. JavaScript can also be run at the server as in Microsoft Active Server pages before the page is sent to the requester. Both Microsoft and Netscape browsers support JavaScript, but sometimes in slightly different ways. Ajax. Ajax is a method of building interactive application for the web that process user requests immediately. Ajax combines several programming tools including JavaScript, dynamic HTML, extensible markup language, cascading style sheets, the document object model, and the Microsoft Object XML HTTP request. Ajax allows content on web page to update immediately when a user performs an action, unlike an HTTP request during which users must wait for a whole new page to load. For example, a weather forecasting site could display local condition known on one side of the page without delay after a user types in a zip code. The server. The server in a web application is what listens to requests coming in from the client. When you set up at an HTTP server, you set it up to listen to a port number. A port number is always associated with the IP addresses of a computer. You can think of ports as separate channels on each computer that you can use to perform different tasks. One port could be surfing Facebook.com, while another fetches your email. This is possible because each of the applications use different port numbers. Once you have set up an HTTP server to listen to a specific port, the server waits for client requests coming to the specific port, performs any action stated by the request, and sends any request data via an HTTP response. The database. Database are the basement of web architecture. A database is a place to store information so that it can easily be accessed, managed, and updated. If you are building a social media site, for example, you might use a database to store information about your users, posts, and comments. When a visitor requests a page, the data entered into the page comes from this site database, allowing for the real-time user interactions we take for granted on sites like Facebook or apps like Gmail. Internet security. Internet security encompasses browser security, the security of data entered through a web form, and overall authentication and protection of data sent via internet protocol. Internet security relies on specific resources and standards for protection data that gets sent through the internet. This includes various kinds of encryption, such as pretty good privacy. Other aspects of a secure web setup include firewalls, which blocks unwanted traffic and anti-malware, and anti-spyware and antivirus programs that work from specific networks or devices to monitor internet traffic for dangerous attachments. Thank you for your attention.